A government pledged to abolish an unfair rating system now finds itself trying to convince its own backbenchers that a community charge on all adults would be fairer. They wanted to avoid the inevitable uproar and unpopularity that would follow a revaluation of the property values the rates are based on. But their alternative is seen as a poll tax and a tax that treats rich and poor as equals. When the cabinet meet tomorrow, they're expected to agree a phased transfer from rates to community charge, but critics say they'll never blur the divide between winners and losers. In Camden, for example, an average rates bill of £759 per household will be replaced by a community charge of £782 per adult. In Westminster, two adult households would just be better off. Waltham Forest and Ealing might well find themselves rate capped this time tomorrow, but in most of outer London, most families would pay more in community charges than rates. In conservative spending boroughs like Bromley and Croydon, two adults would pay less. But in Southwark, pity the Waters family of 11 adults who would see a rates bill of £440 soar to a total community charge of £6,270.
Some of my families are on the low earning wage, some of them are unemployed, and my husband is on infidelity, a sickness benefit.
From what I can gather, we're going to be subsidising the people in the rest of the street. And we're living on the same plot, similar-sized plot of ground.
Less extreme examples were enough to worry Robin Squire, an original opponent of a charge he considers unfair and unworkable.
It's widely accepted, whether one is a supporter or opponent, that the community charge will be harder to assess, harder to collect and more expensive to collect, and will involve much greater evasion than, of course, the rating system does, which is, by and large, very difficult to evade.
But John Wheeler likes the accountability argument and the benefits for his constituency.
Westminster will come out of this better. It simply is intolerable that the people of Westminster should be funding other local authorities and thus enabling those authorities to get away with incompetence. It's time all of that nonsense ended.
Local Government Minister Michael Howard is meeting London MPs for and against the community charge now, trying to convince the doubters.
What we are putting into place is a very radical change, and it's not surprising that people have questions they want to ask, have concerns that they want to put to me, and I'm very anxious to listen to what they have to say.
Among the worried are a former Environment Minister, a former Environment Secretary and a former Prime Minister who've all presumably seen the inside papers on this matter. Are you convinced it's going to be fair?
Quite convinced. The unfairness of the existing system becomes more and more blindingly obvious with every year that passes. The time has come to grasp this nettle. That's what we're doing. And we're going to put into place a vastly more effective, more efficient and more accountable system of paying for local government.
But there are a lot of details to be worked out first. David Bellinet, Westminster for Thames News.